present Galbraith and the King of Diamonds by Robert Barr, with Bernard Hepton, Tom Watson, Richard Davies, Peter Dinley, and Eva Haddon. Episode 1, in which Galbraith retires, is entitled Enter a Frightened Lady.
I've never seen so many taxis. Do we take one?
Oh, we can walk, boy. It won't take long.
Is it a mystery tour, or can I ask where you're taking me?
Well, it's meant to be a surprise, Eva, I'm sure you can guess.
Can I? The old yard still looks good. It's always a powerful building. Is this where we're going?
No.
It's a pity. I'd have liked that. Tonight. It's where we first met Tommy. Put in most of my service there. Never liked the new place. Daft sort of name it has, the new place. New Scotland Yard.
Well, we turn right here. This way.
I should never have trusted you, Tom Evans.
Well, you managed to get him here, Tom. Any trouble?
I had to twist his arm.
I didn't expect to meet you tonight, sir.
Well, if you wouldn't come to us, we had to lay a trap for you. A surprise party. The others are waiting. This way. Quiet, everyone, please. Your attention. Our guests have arrived. Now, first, let's welcome an old friend who is still known to many of you at the Yard. Ex-Commander Tom Evans. And someone known to all of you, a colleague, and the reason for this get-together, Detective Superintendent Bill Galbraith.
Glad you came, Bill.
No.
We are gathered here this evening for what is called a pleasant occasion, although some of us, and I include myself, would rather it had been longer delayed. The quite untimely departure from our midst of this very good but stubborn friend. Now, I know some of you think that if a little pressure is applied in the right places, he might be persuaded to stay. Well, let's try. Do we have his file and his record?
Here it is, sir. Straight from criminal records with all the facts.
Thank you. Now, are we all ready? Well, stand up, Bill. Let him see you. Full name, William Galbraith, also known at the Yard as Billy the One. Billy Boy, the Quiet One. And known to certain villains as that big Rosa from the squad. And certain other names I needn't repeat. Born Edinburgh, 5/11/35, which makes him much too young to be leaving us.
He's only a lad, sir.
They say he looks older in the dark. Joined the force at 19. Now, the villainous details. Height 6'1", weight 13 stone. Eyes brown, hair brown. Marks and scars various. And no doubt he'll show them when he's had a drink.
Give him a drink then, eh?
Came down to the smoke to service as a rookie. Then as aide to CID. Detective Constable, Detective Sergeant, Detective Inspector. And now he's Detective Superintendent. Earned 5 commendations. Well, if that isn't grounds for suspicion. Has served us in CID, Flying Squad, Murder Squad, Special Crime Squad. More recently in Criminal Records, Fingerprint Branch. Forensic and Interpol. Then he slipped into Criminal Intelligence. Took a look at our files and wants to leave. What should we do with him?
Make him run the lines.
I've given you a list of his aliases. Now we come to his criminal friends and associates. A formidable list. I'll pass it round and ask you, should he be allowed to leave?
No! Now,
come on, Bill, you've heard them. We'd like you to change your mind. You still have time. You have 10 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5 seconds, 4, 3, 2, 1. You're out.
Hey, someone's nicked a present, sir.
Present from the Flying Squad, Bill, with our best wishes.
Thanks, Jack.
From B Division, sir. Hoping you won't forget us.
Thanks, sir.
From Central, sir. We believe you mentioned gardening.
Did I? Thanks, Jean.
And now, Bill, the official one. From the Yard, with the Commissioner's compliments. We are sorry you're leaving us.
Thank you, sir.
Speech!
Speech!
Come on, speech!
I look like a Christmas tree.
Put it down, then.
Well, I don't know what to say.
Oh.
If I said I was sorry to be leaving, it would be too late, and you would take it as a misleading statement. At this moment, I am sorry to be leaving so many good friends. We've been through lots of trouble and lots of excitement together, but this moment will pass. This copper is really getting out of it. So, I will read this book, drink from this silver tankard, use this lovely watch to mark the passage of time, my own time, free time. I'll do all this on some sunny beach, and I'll think of you as you patrol the darkened streets of London, nick villains, find fingerprints, send things to the lab, pore over your records, type charge sheets, practice at the shooting range, and keep the Queen's peace. For me, my peace will be my own while I'm still young enough to enjoy it. Thank you all.
It's all over, Bill.
Yes.
It wasn't too bad, was it?
A lot of fuss. And a lot of loot.
And a lot of friends. It isn't often one of the bright lads leaves them. I mean, this dinner was to mark the occasion, you see. Have some more coffee.
Yes, yes, black as it comes. I'll say this, Tom. It was a marvellous dinner. It was almost worth resigning for.
Oh, well, they thought they could get you to stay?
Never.
Well, to your new life, Bill.
To a quiet life.
So you're still refusing my offer?
It's a generous offer, Tom, and I appreciate it. But you heard what I said to the lads. I'm finished with being a copper. I want quiet evenings at my own local, where I don't have to drink with villains.
Half the villains in London will be celebrating tonight.
Maybe.
What now?
Victoria, I'm going down to the country.
Oh, I'll give you a lift.
Oh, thanks.
Oh, I'll have to stop off at my office for a moment. Do you mind?
No.
There's something I want to show you.
Is this what you want to show me? Your office?
What do you think of it?
It's big. It's impressive.
Oh, you should see the rest of the setup. We have two floors here. The biggest private investigation service in London. The busiest in Europe. Have a drink?
Scotch? Thanks. Hey, hey, go easy with it, Tom. I'm on my way home with precious gifts.
Oh, park them over there. And say when.
More soda.
Here you are.
Ta.
That offer I made you, Bill. You could have had this office.
No thanks. It has a desk.
Oh, you could take over from me. Run the place.
I've given my answer, Tom, to the commander and to you. Now, don't press it.
I just wanted to make it clear to you. With your experience, leaving the force is a waste.
You left the force?
Well, I didn't run off and leave my experience to rot. I set up this place. It's successful. It's busy. It's exciting. It's lucrative. And it does a great deal of good. I built it on my experience.
I'm impressed. But you made commander before you left. All I made was superintendent.
At your age, I wasn't even superintendent. I mean, you could have made commander. Was it because they didn't give you the murder squad?
I was offered it. I was on the list. But instead, they pulled me inside and made me push paper around.
A chip on your shoulder?
No.
I think there is. I trained you, remember? I always knew you were a loner. They forgot, that's all.
It was still pushing paper for 2 years.
But what paper? I mean, you know more about the Yard, more about criminals. Know more faces than anyone I know.
Is that what you want to buy?
For the public good?
I don't preach, Tom. The answer's still no. And you said you wouldn't press it. Cheers.
Cheers.
What time is it?
Oh, you still have some time. I want one little piece of advice before you disappear for that holiday in the sun. It's a case that's worrying us. Will you listen?
I'm a very good listener.
2 days ago, I had a visitor. A young woman.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.